Well, this morning we are tracking the weather that is moving into the mid-state. We're already beginning to see significant weather advisories be issued. That's sticking further south in spots like Crisp County and Dooley County as of this morning. Now, that is going to be following that severe weather advisory that took place in Albany earlier. As you can see all across here, plenty of moderate rainfall, but you're really seeing that heavy rain just south of Thomaston over here. Now over here, this is where you're going to potentially see a severe thunderstorm warning come down in the next few minutes. We did see a very similar setup earlier this morning towards our north in Atlanta, where they had a severe thunderstorm warning, and you can see that just south of Thomaston, few lightnings, lots of heavy rain. That's what they're looking at to start off the day. Now we are looking at a tornado watch as well. That's going to be in the background here. You can see it really only encompasses spots like Upson County, Macon County, and Taylor County, and really down towards our south. At the moment, most of Middle Georgia is not going to be underneath that threat, but I'm going to be keeping you updated all morning on that system to let you know what you can expect out there. So this is all part of a squall line that's slowly making its way through Middle Georgia, and you can see right here that front is going to be following it, and whenever that front passes us, our severe weather chances will be over at that point. And when it comes to that severe threat level, that has dropped a bit. Since yesterday, we have fallen from a 3 to a 2. Now a 2 is still enough to cause things like tornadoes out there, potential for a couple isolated ones, along with some strong winds. And guys, that wind is the biggest thing to watch out for today. That's going to be a very high threat. Even though our threat of severe weather has come down, that threat of strong wind is still going to be there throughout the entire day. In fact, many of us could see wind gusts between 40 and even 60 miles per hour out there in the strongest areas. You can see lots of us here in Middle Georgia expecting it to be at least 30 by the middle of the day today. Now I want to go over the timing of this system real quick, because it's really been all over the place over the past few days. Many of us are going to be expecting the heaviest rain to move into spots like Macon and Warner Robins closer to about 9:30 to 10 o'clock. After that, it's going to begin to form very, very quickly in portions like Sandersville, Wrightsville, and Dublin. Over here, you're going to see these smaller cells popping up that could either be severe thunderstorms or potentially even some tornado warnings to come down in that area. Now, further down towards the south, you're going to have more of this rain coming on up. Basically the same thing that we had yesterday, just some light rain passing us by, and we should be all clear by later this evening before we have a great weekend ahead. Next thing I want to talk about is going to be that potential for heavy rain, because we've already seen a number of flash flood warnings with this front. There was two over Mississippi yesterday, two in northern Georgia earlier this morning, and we still could see close to a full inch of rain here in middle Georgia over the next few hours, which could cause potential for some minor flash flooding out there. Now, as far as the next 10 days are concerned, we're not looking at any more good chances of thunderstorms until we get to next Friday. If you're trying to make plans for Easter Sunday, it's looking like an excellent day. Might need a jacket for early if you plan on going out there, but if you want to make plans during the afternoon, you should be just fine. And now here's going to be a quick look at your fish and game forecast, brought to you by Harrison's Body Shop. The best time